Hi everyone, hope you guys are taking great care of yourselves as well as others. Welcome back to Airbus Boys new episode. In this video, we'll be talking about different interviews, airline as well as MRO. It doesn't matter whether you are a OJT student, a college student or a fresher. This video is meant for everyone. Stay tuned.
In aviation, there are two types of interview. MRO's interview, airline's interview. So, we're gonna discuss both types of interview one by one. But before we proceed further, I want to give a short explanation of an MRO. That stands for Maintenance, Repair and Overhaul. So, बात करें अगर हम अपने तीसरे टॉपिक के ऊपर जो कि है मॉड्यूल्स, तो आपको फुल नॉलेज होना चाहिए उन मॉड्यूल्स के ऊपर जिसे आपने क्लियर किया है। मोस्टली ऐसा देखा गया है कि जो क्वेश्चंस पुट होते हैं वो बेसिक एरोडायनेमिक्स से ज़्यादा पूछे जाते हैं, तो आपको बेसिक एरोडायनेमिक्स की पूरी नॉलेज होनी चाहिए। एंड आवर लास्ट टॉपिक इज मिसलेनियस questions that frequently ask in interview from this topic is simply like a conversion definition, like what is torque, what are the different types of torque. So if you want to prepare yourself for this topic, please read module 6 and module 7 so that you can easily get knowledge about tools and conversions and definitions.
Thanks Chandragupt for such enlightening explanation. So this was all about MROs. Now head up to the next level, that is airlines interview. So further down in this video we'll be talking about how to deal with this airline interview and what to keep in mind when you are on your OJT or going for it. So if I was to rate the difficulty level of this interview, I will say somewhere between 6 and 8. But that doesn't mean that they are easy. I will say that they are tricky to deal with. Before giving you an idea about how does the interview goes, first let me explain how and what topics you all have to cover. So preparation for an airline interview simply means to deal with an entire aircraft, because this is what they operate. So your preparation starts right when your OJT starts. because that's the most common eligibility criteria for appearing in this interview. So if you haven't watched our video on OJT yet, it is available on the top right corner. For this interview, you have to be well prepared for the basics of aircraft you have worked upon and the basics of subjects like CAR, aerodynamics, human factors, because these are what they want you to be good at initially. Moving deep into the system, prepare about hydraulic system, flight control system, air conditioning basics, fire protection, landing gear nomenclatures, different ground operations, engine starting procedures, and last but not the least, APU. One of the most commonly important topics that you should be knowing in depth are IDG, wheel and brakes, into charging, reservoir and accumulator servicings, and some basic engine related tasks that you have done on your OJT. So from where you will study all this? Answer is nowhere. There is no book that will teach you parking brake accumulator charging. All this comes to you when you have performed these tasks or assisted in them, then only you will be able to tell their procedure. Other than that, there is no fair way. Another most important thing to keep in mind is to have keen knowledge and concept understanding of whatever modules you have cleared. Because this is where most people fail at and start the biggest myths of all time, that companies do not hire students with maximum number of modules. Oh come on, just tell me who will not like to have a person on board with keen knowledge, concept understanding, as well as handful number of modules with him. But the mistake people do here is that they feel their responsibility is completely gone away after completing their module. But no, this end is the new beginning. You have to ensure that you are knowledgeable about those modules at all times, so that whenever someone asks you about questions related to that module, it is totally acceptable that this is the person who has cleared this module by study. Also, whatever you speak here in these interviews comes up directly from what you have seen, done, or learned during your OJT. So that's a very crucial part, you see. Then exactly what basics you have to pick up from there. So in this part of the video, we'll be discussing what are the basics or what are the do's and don'ts that you have to consider while you are on your OJT. First of all, getting OJT or being on OJT right now is quite a big task as of now. But if you are the lucky guy, then you shouldn't be the person that is just watching an aircraft take off and land, but should be the person that is exploring the aircraft to its brim. So our point number one, get yourself deeply familiarized about the aircraft you are going to work upon. Don't just overlook any topic thinking that it is out of my league. Instead, focus on every aspect of it. Our point number two, you have to be clear at every component operation you see. So don't be just a watch monkey. You are human being for a reason. Use your brain, find out things, ask questions about every single hole you can discover externally on an aircraft. Refer to books, ask for maintenance manual, study them. I am emphasizing strongly upon this because this will not only help you in clearing the interviews, but also help you in revising the overall syllabus that you have studied in your college. Our third point, pay attention to the smallest things you can discover around you. Take a look at the toolbox, know all of their names, ratchets, spanners, Allen key, their purpose, their sizes, everything. These all might seem small things to you, but they are capable of making big differences when it comes to results. So before moving down further into the video, I'm making things more spicy. So let me add a bonus point here for everyone. For students who are in college, for those who have passed out and yet not faced any interview, or students who are in their OJT, there is a bonus point for you that you should not mention, or you should mention only those tasks on your CV that you are confident about. Don't make things messy just to make a fancy CV. Don't write heavy sophisticated tasks because they are only going to increase your problems and do no good to you. Writing heavy base maintenance tasks on your CV simply means that you are decreasing your favorable outcomes. Our next point to focus upon is to make notes of whatever you learned there. Yes, you probably could remember it, but we are serious about everything here. So make a dedicated notebook of OJT. Write it in on daily basis of whatever you have learned. Believe me, I'm telling you this because of my own experience, and for sure it will be a game changer for you. My next point for you will be to try to approach the most basic side of the task at first go. For example, the simplest and the toughest question one can ask you in an interview could be from a simple torque wrench. Yes, a simple torque wrench. Most people ignore them, but they don't know that these are and will be the most important daily tool in aircraft maintenance. Apart from this, no matter you are in second semester or at OJT, the things I am telling you in this video are still to be kept in mind for future endeavors. So guys, practical understanding के साथ साथ books भी उतना ही importance रखती हैं। तो जैसा कि मैंने आपको बताया कि आपको practical understanding के लिए सारे concept और सारे components का working पे ध्यान देना चाहिए, manuals पढ़ना चाहिए, लेकिन साथ ही साथ आपको अच्छी books like AMR, 9A और इन सब books को आपको भूलना नहीं है, because इन सब books में वो quality content है जो आपको हमेशा काम आएगा, whether you are a first year student या फिर आप इंटरव्यू के लिए प्रिपेयर कर रहे हो, या फिर आप OJT पे हो, या फिर आप मॉड्यूल के लिए प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो, ये बुक्स सबसे बेसिक बुक्स हैं जो हमेशा आपको यूज़ में आएंगी, इसलिए नेवर फॉरगेट टू रेफर दीज बुक्स। इसलिए मैं हमेशा आपको बोलता रहूँगा कि OJT के टाइम भी आप जैसे ही रूम पे पहुँचो, शाम में आराम करो, उसके बाद आप रूटीन सेट कर लो कि आपको कुछ टाइम देना है इन बुक्स को, कुछ टॉपिक पढ़ना है, और फिर अगले दिन एयरक्राफ्ट पे जाके आपको वही सेम टॉपिक उठाना है और वही सेम कंपोनेंट ढूंढना है और क्वेश्चंस पूछने हैं। One of the world's best. Plus, the key aspect of every interview, of course, that you should never forget is to first know about the company. Because if you are unaware of the workplace that you are going to be a part of, then how can one believe on your skills? So viewers, this was it for today. Hope you guys liked the video. Video ko yahan tak dekh liya ho, to like, share aur subscribe karna mat bhulna. And yes, ये भी ध्यान देना कि आपने बेल नोटिफिकेशन को प्रेस किया है कि नहीं, जिससे कि नेक्स्ट टाइम हम जब भी वीडियो डालें आपको नोटिफिकेशन हो जाए। एंड वी प्रॉमिस यू एज ऑलवेज कि आपको अच्छा और नॉट सो कॉमन कंटेंट दिखाते रहेंगे। सो थैंक यू गाइस फॉर मेकिंग अस अ पार्ट ऑफ योर डे। लव फ्रॉम एयरबस बॉयज़।